Hello Ace, this is RetroTK2 and welcome to this C# tutorial. Today we're looking at an extension for Visual Studio called VSCommands. We will install it and talk about its features. You may need some C# knowledge to fully understand the benefit of this extension, Ace, but we'll see how we get on. So let's get started. Launch Visual Studio and wait for it to load, Ace. It may show up with a start page, which can be disabled by clicking on the Show Page on Startup checkbox. Close this page by clicking the X beside the tab. Click on Tools, Extensions and Updates, and when the window shows up, click the Online drop-down button. Type VSCommands into the search field, and once it has loaded the results, click the Download button. It's worth noting that this version of VSCommands is currently being ported over from Visual Studio 2013. This means it's missing a lot of its features, Ace. Once the download is finished, click Install. You'll have to restart Visual Studio when it's done. After a brief startup sequence, you'll be back into Visual Studio. You can enable and disable the extension at any time. Click on Tools, Extensions and Updates, and make sure that the Install drop-down button is selected. Scroll down to the bottom and click on VSCommands. Here you can enable and disable the extension. You will need to restart Visual Studio if you set it to a different state. Let's check out the features of VSCommands. Type VSCommands into Google and click on the first link. Click on the Features button and they should be listed at the side. This page also shows you where to find the VSCommands options in Visual Studio. If you go to Visual Studio and click on Tools, VSCommands options would usually be the first choice. Unfortunately, these haven't been implemented in this version, Ace. The solution badges are a pretty nice feature. Here's what the taskbar looks like without them. And here it is with them. You can also customize the badges and set it so that they appear on the start screen. I personally don't use this, Ace, but it could be useful. Strangely enough, the solution badges are meant to be a pro-only feature, but as you can see, they are available with the Lite version. Not sure if this is a mistake or a misprint, Ace. Either way, it's a win for us. The main reason for downloading VSCommands is this little feature. This is the code block end tagger. It displays a code block's top line at the end of the block. You can also click on this text and it will bring you to the top of the block. Unfortunately, I can't show you this in Visual Studio, Ace, since this feature hasn't been ported over yet. As with the solution badges, this is a pro-only feature, but it was available in the 2013 Lite version, and the solution badges are available in this Lite version, so who knows, maybe it will be available in both. Other features include different color fonts in the output window, debugging as a different user, and touch commands for tablet devices. I personally have never had any need for these features, Ace, but maybe you will. Let's look at the licenses available. Now, for the longest time, I thought that VSCommands was completely free. It's only since making this video that I've learned that this isn't the case. The Lite version is allowed for open source and personal projects. It is not allowed to be used on commercial projects. I would be tempted to buy a license if the price was a wee bit more reasonable, but the only feature I care about is the code tagger stuff, which I would value at about $10, maybe $20 at a stretch, but not $49. This means I'm going to have to remove VSCommands, Ace. On the plus side, it does mean I get to show you how to uninstall an extension. Head back into Visual Studio, click on Tools, Extensions and Updates, and make sure the Install drop-down button is selected. Scroll down to the bottom, click on VSCommands, click on Install, and restart Visual Studio. Sorry that this video has done a bit of a U-turn, Ace. VSCommands is a great little extension, but it's just too overpriced in my opinion. Hopefully you liked it enough to buy it, Ace. I'll be waiting for it to come down to a more suitable price, but I doubt it'll ever happen. And that's it. Rate, comment and subscribe, Ace. Any support is greatly appreciated. You can email me at retrotk2@gmail.com if you have any Visual Studio extensions you can't live without. I'd love to hear them, Ace. Thank you for watching, Ace, and I'll see you in the next video.